Hello and welcome to Hacknet. This is a game on Steam, basically a simulator of hacking. Now, I have done a little bit of hacking in the past, so I should know what I'm doing. I thought I would give this a try, see if it's very close to an actual penetration system, but let's see if we can hack ET's phone and disable all communications with home. So we're gonna start a new session here. Now I do not really know what to expect of this, so yeah. Confirm password. I've never seen this. I really pressed it. Okay. What just happened there? Okay, boot up sequence seems to be in order. But yeah, I've only seen a few posts here and there about the Hacknet. Then again, I don't really read a lot of it. 40-day timer has expired. Initialing fails safe. Hi. This is strange. Stranger than I expected. I guess I'm supposed to write this in the past tense, but I hardly feel like admitting it's over. My name is Bit, and if you're reading this, I'm already dead. Okay, this is at all not creepy. So I've got a dead person hacking my own system. Okay. So I have to... Okay, I thought I'd put the music down. Put it even down more. A lot of changes. Okay. As of right now, you are at risk. Really? Learn as quickly as possible. Begin the tutorial sequence by pressing the continue button. Oh, okay. Oh, that was loud. Connect to your computer by typing connect to IP, or just click the green circle. Okay. Good work. Good work, that was masterful performance on clicking on that circle, I must say so myself. The first thing to do on any system is scan it for adjacent nodes. This will reveal more computers on your map that you can use. Scan this computer now by pressing the scan network button. Okay. That should be all you need from your own server for now. Disconnect from your machine. Disconnect, okay. It's time for you to connect to an outside computer. Be aware that attempting to compromise the security of another's computer is illegal under the USC Act 1038, it seems. Proceed at your own risk and connect to the outside machine. Click on the network on the map. Okay. This virtual machine's terminal module has been activated. This will be your primary interface for navigating and interacting with nodes. A command can be run by typing it out and pressing enter. Computer security system and open ports analyze using the probe. Oh, we're gonna probe some systems. Let's see. Just have to type in probe. Awesome. Here you can see the active ports, active security, and number of open ports required. Okay, I assume that's okay, only zero. Okay, so that's fine. This machine has no active security regulations, no open ports to crack it. If you are prepared to, it is possible to connect this computer using the program PortHack. Run the program PortHack. Okay, PortHack. Let's see. Oh, that's awesome. Okay, congratulations. You have taken control of an external system for now. It's administrator. You are now its administrator. You can do whatever you like with it. However, you should start scanning it for local nodes with the scan command. Let's scan it. So we did not find find anything. No results. Not a problem. Next, you should investigate the file system under the files directory. Okay. Navigate to the bin folder. Okay. Binaries folder. To search for useful executable using the command cd folder name. I would assume you have to put in the forward slash also. Cd for the bin. Awesome. You can view the contents of the current folder you are in use. The command ls. Ls list, so that should give us a list. Ls. Ah, there. Only shows config.txt, which is the only file in there. Okay, then we can open that. Yeah, basic. Totally useless. Now to clear your tracks before you leave. Move up the folder directory using cd. The wild card indicates back or up. Cd. Awesome. Move to the locks folder. So cd lock. CD lock. Aha. You can delete files by rm file name. However, you can delete all the files in current directory with this rm star. Okay. That's awesome. So let's try that rm star. And then we just need to DC. Okay, so far so good. But when do we get to the real action? This is peanut stuff. Congratulations, you have completed the guide section of this tutorial. To finish, you must locate the process ID of this on your computer and kill it. The help command will give you help. Let's see, we've got help, we've got SCP. Okay, that's to copy a file, scan, right? RM to remove files, PS lists all the current running processors and their PIDs. And then kill PID kills process number. Ha! So first we run the PS. We've got root tutorial. And we say kill 233. Awesome. What do we have today? I've got an email. Well, I thought I'm disconnected from my computer. Well, but first contact. I don't know you, and I'm sad to say this. I never will. But if you're reading this, this means you might be the only person that can make things right. Right now I'm trapped. There's no way out, and not enough time, and I need your help. Everybody needs my help these days. But there's something you need to take care of first. The faster the better. Hacknet OS wasn't meant to be released as it is now. After a while, an automated tracker will activate itself. We can't let that happen. Connect to your own node. It should be green on your netmap, and then find and delete security tracer.exe. When you're done, just reply to this email. Okay. So we need to find that specific folder on... Oh, that was a good case. Yes, get tracer. What was that? RM. Start to remove all of them. Okay. Okay, then he said we must just reply to his email. Don't need to send any details. Okay, that was quite an easy task. Great, that should keep you safe for now, at least from your own computer. Before we start, you're going to need a few things. PortAC alone isn't going to cut it for most modern computers you will find. Not ones with anything worth looking at anyway. This is quite true. You should start by checking up on a friend of mine. He goes by Viper. Awful, I know. He's honestly not the brightest crayon in the box, but he always seems to get all of the useful code. You should have no trouble getting into his files. Finding something useful might be a bit more of a challenge. You can, for the most part, ignore the generic files, stuff that gets locked or saved by programs, IRC logs and the like. Custom name things like .exe files are what you want to look out for. Download any files you can use using the command scp. Good luck. Okay. Reply again when you're done. Okay. Wait. There was something. Link. Aha. Awesome. Okay, let's go check out this guy's computer. So first order of business, probe it. Okay, then port hack it. Okay, so that's awesome. Okay, let's view his files, see what he's got home. Okay, so EXEs are worth a lot, apparently. Logs. Yes. What was that? SCP. Okay. SCP to download. Then SSH. I wonder if you can use the tab command. It works. Haha. Makes life a lot easier. Transfer completed. Okay. So, let's go to his system file. Not much there to actually look at. Log file. Let's remove our trace. And let's disconnect. Okay, so we've got the EXE, that's the important part. So now we only have to reply. Awesome. Okay, maiden flight. Congratulations. I honestly have no way of knowing if you succeeded in this responder. But if you're seeing this, it means you at least found something. I'm going to assume it's something really useful. You should try breaking one of my old test servers. If Viper had the sort of thing he's known for getting lying around, you should have everything you need to get in. Remember, any non-basic programs you get need a port number to run, like this. SSH crack 22 file name port number. Okay, that's easy. Just find the port you want to crack and run it on that. Oh, and in case you don't know already, you can hit tab to autocomplete commands. Hitting SSH then tab should autocomplete it in full name. Works for everything. Oh, so that should make downloading files easier. Security basics? Don't really need to do that, I don't think. Bitwise. Okay. Let's see if we can get in. First command probe. Okay. Oh, no, see, at the top it actually says you need to crack at least one port to get in. So we're gonna run SSH, and that is port 22 for the SSH port. So let's see. Oh, that's awesome. I love that. Okay, cool. So now port hack. See if we can hack a port to get in. Awesome, we're in. Okay. View file system. See home. Test file. LAX. Okay, I don't need that. Congratulations, you went awesome. Logs, bin, nothing about system, nothing. Log. Let's remove our traces. And then we'll DC from that, okay. So, it doesn't. Okay. Cool. Something in return. Nice work. Here's where it's going to start getting harder. I need to ask a favor. I've been a little sloppy lately, which is what got me into this whole mess. It's why I'm writing this in the first place, I guess. Anyway, the point is there's some logs on a few computers that I'd prefer weren't there. You should remember this. If you forget everything else I tell you, don't get sloppy. Delete your logs. If you haven't been, start now. Everything you do on a modern OS can be tracked to your track and locked in a log folder. Just go in there and RM star the whole thing. Never forget to. Thanks, good luck. Okay, Mr. Anderson, we meet again. Let's see how to get into your computer. Apparently the Matrix isn't as secure as they advertised. Doesn't matter. Just makes it easier to save everyone. Port hack. Port hack done. Awesome. Okay. Let's view. Files. Ah. CD. Home. CD. Work. Ah, that doesn't work. That's fine. Documents, personal letter, draft, laptop, text, supporter, work. Not really anything in here. Okay. This guy did a few things. We need to get rid of all this. No one would know what to do. Okay, awesome DC. Alright, we've done that for you, Mr. Bit. where to go from here. Alright, if you see this, then you've done well, and well, all this might actually be worth something. So is he actually congratulating me? Is that too much to hope for? It seems like a lot to hope for. I've realized that I just don't have time to write this whole thing. There's way too much to learn, and I don't have time to do any of it. So I'm going to need to ask something more. But this guy actually wrote a hacking software program, but he doesn't have time to learn more. Okay, that doesn't make sense. Not to me, at least. There's a group that goes by Entropy. That's currently accepting members. They'll be able to teach you more. When you're ready, I'll connect you again. As for getting into Entropy, you'll need to bypass proxy server, a few shells open using command shell, running on computers you've already got admin access on should be able to overload it. Good luck. Don't forget, if you run into trouble, I've linked the network education archive server too. It's got a lot of useful info on it. This shouldn't be too difficult. Test server. Okay. That's the education. Let's go to the test server. Probe it first. What the hell did I type? Probe. that's like a manly version of probing. Captain, I can't do that now. I must first put in some shells. Shell. Okay, got a shell there. Bitwise test piece in education or Gmail, no? And we'll use him as well. System lock. And Mr. Anderson's PC as well. Okay, now we've got our shells in place. Where's that test server? There it is. Okay, once again, probe it. Proxy detector. To use these overloads, let's get our SSH ready. 22. Proxy bypass. Let's run it. Okay, not bad. Port hacket. And we should be in. Awesome. Let's view that message of the system also. Home. Induction test. Congratulations. Download this file to complete your induction test. Entropy will be contacting you shortly. Okay. Got bin zero cool. Hack the planet. OP Stormwind need help. Admins are lazy. 50 gold TXT. Bit leasery. That's for bit. If you are lurking, can you please come out of the shadows? I need to talk to you. Vapor won't get off my case saying something's wrong. She's sure something's going on. Let me know. Okay, so this guy is a bit in deep. Makes me wonder what I'm doing. Probably not be anything good. Let's just clear this out and Okay, done. Cheerio. Okay. I really need to get properly. Not sure I should reply to anything. Mission incomplete. The XE files. Education archives. Not sure if I'm actually supposed to crack this thing as well. Firewall analysis. Okay, yeah, this might be important. Firewalls have been around for a very long time. Computer security, most often serving to prevent automated foreign network traffic rather than secure against dedicated hackers. Modern firewalls, however, can be configured to prevent all security critical traffic unless it is prefixed by a firewall solution, often referred to as password to end users, but there is a distinct difference between the two. In this solution, the firewall solution will need to be provided before an unsyndicated login attempt can be attempted, effectively meaning that any known password cracking software will be useless while the firewall is active. Firewall complexity can be examined with the analyze command. Running the analyze command multiple times automatically detect patterns in the response data header and will eliminate characters it can guarantee are not part of the correct firewall solution. Once a potential firewall solution is found, the command solve firewall solution can be used to attempt the syndicate. Okay, that I should remember. Analyze and solve. Let's see if we can probe this system. Proxy, firewall, open post request for crack 5, but there's only one. Okay, this guy is he's good. He's really good. Okay. But I cannot really see anything here. Okay, I've realized you don't have to download the whole thing. There's a group go by interprofi, teach you. To interfere, you'll need to bypass a proxy server. Okay. Bypass the proxy server. That I've got. The one thing I didn't do is run a scan. Ah, no scans. Scan complete, nothing there. And I've read that, so contacting you shortly, but they haven't. So so for now I'm not exactly sure what I should be doing. That's the proxy server info. Shells, we've already done all that. Okay. So, what do we actually need to do now? Okay. System files, logs. Oh, nice. Okay. So that's we scanned. Can't even find anything there. Scan this one. Okay, can't find anything there. This one I've scanned. Nothing scanned. Ooh. Connected asset cache. If I type that wrong again. Aha! The firewall thing. So they say I must analyze that. Run this a few more times. Okay. Let's see there. What do we have? D-I-M-E. Okay, so let's say solve time. So, enabled, okay, SSH tab 22. Let's see what we can get off that. Awesome, it's open. Port. Hack the port. This is actually quite an enjoyable game, I must say. Although I don't think in any hacking or bypassing software you would get a screen like this to actually view system files. I haven't seen that yet, but then again I haven't actually looked around specifically for something like it. X clock, that's interesting. SCP, see, X clock. Awesome, so I've got that. CD log RM clear. Okay, let's just do a scan. Nothing, okay. DC. All right, fellow hackers, I think I'll leave this here for today so that I can figure out why these guys haven't contacted me again yet. Next time we'll pick it up from here again. So if you enjoyed it, please leave a like. If you have any suggestions, your own experiences with anything hacking related, please share that. I'd love to read it. And yeah, I think I'll leave it there for now. Thank you very much, guys, and enjoy. Goodbye.